Hi everyone, welcome back. In today's video, I will do the overview and tutorial of MDEX. I will also show you steps to swap tokens, provide liquidity, trading, staking, and everything that they are offering. MDEX is an AMM protocol that runs on the HECO and Binance Smart Chain. Most of you already know about Smart Chain. HECO is almost the same. HECO is Huobi's eco chain, which has very fast block times and very low fees. You need to add the Smart Chain and HECO chain to your MetaMask to start interacting on this website. Adding networks is very easy. Just go to your MetaMask, click on the Networks drop-down, and select the Custom RPC option. Now you need to enter all the details and click Save to add the network. If you want to add HECO chain, add these details. And for the Smart Chain, you need to add these details. Now you need to remember one thing is your wallet address will be the same in all networks. You just need to use the correct address type to deposit in your wallet. For example, if I want to deposit BNB, I need to select BEP20 when I will withdraw from any exchange. And if I will switch to HECO chain, my deposit address will be the same. But I need to select HECO when I will withdraw the HT token from any exchange. Currently, I am on the HECO chain network. You can also use this drop down to switch the network. First, I want to show you the trading option. This is something you won't find on any other DEX. When you trade specific pairs that are listed here, you receive MDEX coin as a reward from the transaction fee. For example, if you will swap HUSD to USDT or USDT to HUSD, you will receive a small amount of MDEX coin as a reward. You will be able to see all your rewards here and on all pages. Now let's see how you can swap tokens. You need HT coin in your wallet to pay transaction fees. If you will use Smart Chain network, you will need BNB coin. I am going to buy MDEX coin because I will use it to provide liquidity. Enter the number of tokens you want to buy. You can also click on the setting icon to change the slippage tolerance and other settings. Now click the confirm swap button. Check all the details and click confirm swap button again. As you can see, the fee on the HECO network is like nothing. Click confirm to pay the fee and complete the transaction. I will also receive MDEX as a reward after the transaction. As you can see, now my MDEX balance has increased to 0.0017, and now I also have some MDEX coin in my wallet. Okay, now let's see how you can add liquidity. Go to the pool option, select add liquidity option. I want to add WHT and MDEX. So I will select WHT in the first field and MDEX in the second field. I want to add the full amount, so I will click the max button. You need to remember one thing is when you provide the liquidity, the value of both coins should be the same. For example, if the current price of one MDEX coin is $2, then you also need to add $2 worth of wrapped HT token. You don't need to calculate the amount, you just need to enter the number of coins in one field and the system will automatically enter the number of coins in another field. Now click on the approve button. You always have to approve everything before you can supply them or trade them. Now click on the supply button. Confirm supply. And confirm the transaction. Now it will go into the pool within few seconds. And every time somebody trades between these pairs, I will be getting money. Now if I will go to your liquidity option, I will see my added liquidity. You can also click on the drop down and here you can add more coins to the liquidity or you can also remove from the liquidity. Now let's see how you can stake added liquidity. Go to the liquidity option. Here they also have the single token option, but I cannot see single token staking here. I can find some single token staking inside the boardroom option. I will show you that after this step. Okay, now select the pair you want to stake. Click on the stake button. I already approved this yesterday, that's why I cannot see the approve button. But when you will stake for the first time, you will see an approve button. After approving the LP, you will see minus and plus icon. Click on the plus icon. Click the max button. Click confirm. And confirm the fee. Now your LP will be staked and you will start earning MDEX tokens. You can use plus button to stake more tokens and minus button to unstake your token. Here you will see your earning and you can also use withdraw button to withdraw your earning. Now if you will go back to the pool option, you won't see your added liquidity. You need to unstake your LP. After that, you will see your added liquidity again. Okay, now let's see the Boardroom option. As I said earlier, here you will see single token staking, but if you will open the LP option, you won't find anything. Here you can stake MDEX to earn MDEX, or you can stake MDEX to earn WST. The advantage of staking a single token is you don't have to worry about impermanent loss. The steps to stake single token are the same. You need to approve the token, then you can stake your token. Then you also get the bridge option. The cross-chain bridge allows you to transfer coins from the Hecko chain to the smart chain, or from the smart chain to the Hecko chain. Here you can also use the Ethereum network, but you cannot switch to Ethereum directly. You need to switch to Ethereum manually. I don't know why the website doesn't load properly when I switch to the Ethereum network. Anyways, after switching to Ethereum, you can transfer coins from Ethereum to both networks, Smart Chain and Hecko Chain. Now the last thing I will show you is Binding Black Hole. Currently this section is under preparation, but Binding Black Hole is like a lottery. After contributing MDEX into the Binding Pool, the user will get a random number. If the number will be exactly the same as the pre-designated winning number, the user will win the prize. Apart from that, they also have DAO for community proposal and voting, and IMO for new project launch on MDEX. Okay, I think this is enough for this video. If you still have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.